Hey everyone, it's Anas. In this video, I'll be showing you 6 easy steps on how to store your car battery. So, if you're locking up your sport car or your old school car, or maybe you're going on a vacation or a road trip, it's very important for you to know how to store your car battery. That way, when you come back, your battery is not dead and it's not damaged. Now, believe it or not, many people think if you don't use your batteries more often, the battery will last a long time. That's not true when it comes to rechargeable batteries and lead acid batteries. Those batteries, all the time, they need to be charged and discharged, charged and discharged. That way, you'll get the max life out of it. Hey everyone, in this channel, we cover everything from batteries to gadget repairs. If you like this kind of videos, please like, share, subscribe to this channel so I can make more videos like these. Let's get into the 6 easy steps. Now, step number one is you want to disconnect your battery cable, the negative black cable and then the positive red cable. Let me get the batteries over here so I can show you exactly what's going on. Stay tuned. Now, this is a top post battery and that's the side post battery. A side post battery means your battery connectors or your battery cables get hooked to the battery from the side. Now, a top post battery, that means you can put your battery cables on a battery from the top. Now, every battery, of course, has positive red, negative black. What you want to do before you take out your cable, locate your red cable and then locate your black negative cable. What you want to do, you want to disconnect the black cable first. Just disconnect it and then move on and disconnect the red positive cable, since most cars have a negative ground. Now, when you come back, what you want to do the opposite way. When you come back from your vacation or from your road trip, you want to connect the red cable first and then the negative cable second. All right, that was step number one. Now, step number two, what you want to do is inspect the battery. So basically take a look at it. Look at the top, look at the sides, look at the back of it, see if there is anything leaking. Now, also every battery in the car, as an example, it has a tray. So the tray basically it goes under the battery. This is a good place for you to see also if there is any acid or water or dirt on the tray. If there is, when you remove your battery, just clean it up with a rug or a sponge. Now, if there was any acid in there, take out the battery, clean it out, dry it out, put it on a dry place, and then wait for a few seconds or a few minutes, and then go back and inspect it. See if it's leaking again. All right, that was tip number two. Now move on to tip number three. What you want to do is you want to clean your battery terminals before you store your battery. What I mean by that is most of the times the battery terminals are dirty, okay? It could be because of grease, dirt, battery protection spray, or maybe corrosion buildup on the battery terminals. Look at the side ones and then look at the top ones, okay? So how do you clean the terminals? Now, you can clean the terminals using maybe a stuff around the house that you have. You can use a wired brush, just brush the terminals, the top ones or the side ones. And then you can use a baking soda and water, spray it on it, brush it, wipe it with the rug. Or you can purchase a battery brush. This brush here will clean your top post battery. You see there's a hole in it. And then you can clean the side post battery from here. So for example, as a side post battery, you look at the battery, you put the brush inside of the battery terminal and you spin it this way, and then you do the same thing to the side, and then you brush the front surface of it. Now with the top post battery, what you want to do, lock it from the other end. You see there's a hole in there, hopefully you can see it good. You put that on the top post and then you spin it. You keep on spinning and spinning and spinning and spinning. I'm not talking about hours, I'm talking about maybe 20 seconds, okay? And then after you clean it, everything should be good. That was tip number three. All right, guys, now tip number four. Some batteries comes sealed, which is maintenance-free batteries. You don't have to maintain it. You don't have to check the water level to it. You don't have to add anything to it. But they still make batteries that have top caps. What you want to do, you want to open these caps up, okay? And then look at the acid level. If the acid level is low, just add distilled water to the recommended level, and then you should be fine. Seal it back up, put the caps back on it, and then put it to the side. All right, that was tip number four. Now, tip number five, which is the most important tip, which is it's the last one, but not least, okay? Tip number five is charging your battery before you store in it. There is two type of chargers. A, which is like this one here, is, you look at the picture of this one here, there's an old school charger. If you have an old school charger with the meter that goes from zero to, I don't know, maybe 100 or 50, you wanna keep an eye on those kind of chargers, because those chargers will not shut off automatically. So, charge your battery for a few hours, go back and look at it. If you see the meter went back to zero, that means the battery is fully charged, disconnect it and leave it alone, okay? Now, B is you gotta use a smart charger. I'm gonna take you to my slot wall. I'm gonna show you the chargers that I have, the chargers that I sell, and then the chargers that I recommend for you, because I'm not gonna recommend anything that I don't know about, that I have not used, that I have not sold to my customers. And if my customers are not happy with it, I'm not gonna sell it or recommend it to any of my YouTube videos. And by the way, after I show you these chargers, if you wanna pause the video, go ahead and take a look at them on the link below, and then come back and watch this video again. But I'm gonna take you there, I'm gonna show you everything that you need to know about the smart chargers. Let's go. All right, so I'm here now by the chargers. The two brands I recommend is either the Battery Tender or the Noco Genesis, the Noco Genius charger, okay? Now, you gotta know also if you got a six, you gotta know if you have a 6-volt battery or a 12-volt battery. All of these chargers are smart chargers, meaning you can set it and forget it, plug it in all year around, and you don't have to do anything to it. What these chargers do is, if your battery is low, it will work really, really hard to charge the battery as fast as possible. Then once the battery reaches maybe around 90% charge, 95% charge, these chargers will go to a trickle mode, which is then it's gonna slow down and it's gonna charge the battery very, very slow. So let's say you left your battery, the charger on the battery for a few days, and then the battery is charged. What's gonna happen? Is the charger gonna continue charging your battery? No, it won't do that. It's gonna shut off. Or maybe what it's going to do also, they will discharge your battery a little bit. So it will drain, and then it will charge it back up. That way the battery don't get lazy. So we'll discharge it and charge it and discharge it and charge it all the time to keep the battery alive. Now this one here is a trickle charger. It's less than 1 amp, it's 0.75 milliamps. It will charge your battery very slow. It's a Battery Tender. The link is below if you wanna check it out. And this charger though will only charge a 12-volt battery. Now, the second charger I recommend to you, it's the same thing. Same milliamps, they're both gonna charge the same speed, they're both gonna do the same thing. But the difference between this one and that one, the Noco Genius on the Battery Tender, is this is a 6 and a 12-volt charger. So if you have a 6-volt battery, maybe your kid's power wheels, or maybe you have a scooter that has a 6-volt battery, or maybe you have a golf cart that takes a 6-volt battery, you can charge those batteries with this one. Now, if you wanna step your game up a little bit, and then you say, you know what? What if I have an AGM battery? What if I have a deep cycle battery that I want to store and I want to maintain over the winter time? What if my car, what if I have a stereo in my car and I have an extra battery in the trunk for my stereo? Then, and that battery is an AGM battery, it's not a flooded battery. These chargers will only do lead acid batteries. You can put them on a deep cycle battery. You can put them on an AGM battery. They're gonna work, but they're not made to charge those kind of batteries. So what you wanna do, you wanna get a charger like this. It's a G1100 Noco Genius. This charger I'll show you here. Hopefully you can see it. By the way, these chargers, they only have green and red light. Red is charging, flashing green is 80% charged, solid green is 100% charged. This charger here, it has an indication. It tells you if your battery is 25, 50% charged, 75% charged, and the last dot, green dot, is 100% charge. So with this charger, it has modes. So it has four modes. It has normal, cold AGM, and then normal, and then lithium. So you can do a 12 on 6-volt if they were just a regular lead acid batteries or AGM, okay? And then you can do a 6-volt normal battery, like a golf cart, or maybe an old school car, and you can do a 12 volt lithium ion battery. So if you have a motorcycle maybe, or ATV, or a jet ski that has a lithium ion battery, this charger will do it. It's also a little bit faster. So this is a 1.1 amp charger. And what this charger will do that these chargers won't, this has a desulfation mode to help with the battery restoration process. Now maybe you'll tell me, now we do have higher chargers, faster chargers. If you're just storing your battery, these are the only chargers you need. You don't need to pay high-end price. Now of course there is a higher, it could be on the web or anywhere you go, maybe a higher price battery, higher price charger, or maybe a lower price charger. Like I said, I'm not gonna recommend anything that I don't sell, I don't have experience with, I don't personally use, and all year round we hear good feedbacks from customers about these chargers. That's why we stock them. Now if you have maybe three, four batteries, maybe your boat battery has four batteries, your boat takes four batteries, or maybe you got a quad, ATV, snowmobile, and you have four batteries or three batteries or maybe five, and then you can tell me, now, so what I gotta do? Do I gotta buy five chargers, five of these? I tell you, no. Only need this one charger with maybe four banks, or maybe you can buy a one charger with six banks, or maybe if you have a shop, a repair shop, a junkyard, maybe a mechanic shop, or maybe your auto dealer. You're not gonna buy 50 of these chargers or 10 of these chargers to charge batteries in volume. So if somebody at home or you got a small shop, you don't need a very, very expensive charger. Maybe you need something like this one. This can charge four batteries at one time, guys. Four batteries. So you don't have to plug four chargers, and you're gonna need four sockets to plug them all and wires hanging around. One charger, one plug, you plug it to a wall, it's gonna give you four banks. Each bank will charge one battery. And then once the battery is charged, this will go to green. And this will go to green. 50% charge is gonna go 50% charge. So you can charge all four batteries at the same time. This charger here has the same specs exactly as this one here, okay? It has lithium ion, 6 volt, 12 volt, AGM, non-AGM, lead acid battery will do it too. So this is just an option if you have more than maybe two batteries that you want to store and you want to take care of them so they'll last you a long time. And you know, when we sell batteries sometimes, customers say, well, you know, the battery died again. We asked, did you charge it winter time? Did you trickle charge it? Did you restore it? No, we just left it on the bike. Of course, it's going to drain. It's not going to die. It's going to drain, but it needs to be charged. Now, the last tip that I have for you is number six, storing your battery the proper way. Now, you don't want to leave your, after you charge, by the way, since we're here, we were talking about the brushes over there. If you want a kit like this, maybe for the future, I forgot to mention this, but since we're here, I'll just mention it here. This is a brush, a battery spray cleaner, and then a battery spray protection. It would work as a grease, but it's very liquidy, so it's not sticky. And then you get the washers that already have grease on them, so your battery doesn't get corroded. Anyway, let's move on to tip number six. Tip number six is storing your battery the proper way. Everyone, please listen to me. So do not leave your battery on the cement floor, on the concrete. Do not leave it anywhere below 30 degrees, because what's going to happen to the battery, 30 degrees is your freezing temperature. Your battery is going to freeze. The acid inside of the batteries are going to freeze. The plates inside of the batteries are going to freeze. When you want to use it, when the time comes, your battery may be dead. When I say dead, like gone bad. Or if you're lucky, it's going to be low in charge. So what you do, you leave it anywhere between 40 to 70 degree temperature, the best way to do it. And then put maybe a piece of cardboard under it, okay? Or maybe a piece of wood under it. Maybe leave it in your basement or somewhere in the closet. Like I said, anywhere you want to put it, go ahead and put it. Just do not leave it on the concrete, on the metal plate under it, nothing like that, because will damage the plates, the battery plates from the bottom. This is it, guys. Hopefully you got value out of this video. Please, if you like it, share it, subscribe it. If you have any questions, put them in the comment below. I'll make sure I'll answer all of them. If you need help assisting, if you need a battery that you can't find, you want me to ship it to you, give me a call, 586-580-2893, Battery Shack in Sterling Heights, Michigan. See you on the next